Hey everybody, I'm Mike Peters.
I'm Rebecca Farina.
And you're watching
LIE. Whoop! Coming up, we have another segment with the Atlantic Supper Girls.
We have a segment from Dr. Harvey Passis.
And we'll have a look back at one of our summer concerts.
Plus, we'll hear from our very own Savvy Senior.
All that and more on
LIE. Incoming.
Oops.
Whoa! That was a good one. I think
crazy.
That's this week's hashtag, right?
Probably.
Before we look at it, let's take a look at last week's hashtag, which was...
Hashtag back to school.
Back to school. Oh, we got this.
Ooh, look at that yummy cake.
It looks delicious. I wish my back to school was that delicious.
I know. That's off to a good start.
And this, oh, brand new school supplies. We both love that,
Love it.
And take a look at these books.
What is that?
It's super old school.
Maybe they're maps.
Yeah.
I remember those roll-up maps in school.
Yeah, I don't remember my school having anything that old. But before we get in, can I take a look at this? This actually, this reminds me of an experience I just had the other day.
What's that?
I have some footage. Why don't we take a look? Yep.
Is that you?
That's me. I'm taking my very first flying lesson.
Oh my gosh.
About to go take a look at Long Island from a new angle, from above. And that's me, I'm pushing the throttle
here
up.
He goes.
Yep. I got to do it all. It was pretty incredible. I got to see Long Island from the sky, about 1,100 feet up. Flew out over Jones Beach. It was absolutely
amazing.
It took my breath away. So that actually brings me to this week's hashtag, which is Hashtag Long Island Skies.
Perfect.
Yep, Long Island Skies. So you guys can feel free to use that hashtag, tag us in social media, and we'll get your pictures on air.
Maybe you should take a flight lesson.
Yeah.
Or just take a beautiful shot of the sky.
Anything you want. And that reminds me, you know, we conquered the sky already.
You conquered the sky.
I conquered the sky. But now it's time to conquer the sea. So should we check back in with Mylon Studer?
Let's check it out, the Supper Girls.
Welcome back to our one-on-one on LIE special with the Supper Girls. Today we're going to learn about what their day-to-day was like on this journey from New York to Miami, and if they made new friends along the way.
Wake up. Breakfast. Wait for the sun to come out a little bit. double check plans.
Weather.
Make sure nothing had changed overnight. And then break down, get on the water, and go. See how far you get. Hopefully you get as far as you planned.
Get to a beach.
Yeah.
Set up camp. Get dinner ready. Pass out.
Pretty much. Yeah, so people followed along our trip, not only through social media, but our GPSs had a live tracking feature. So when we turned it on, you could actually log into the website and see real time where we were.
We charged them via our solar panels.
So we had
solar panels connected to external batteries during the day. And then at night, we would charge our phones, our GPSs, the cameras. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, we did. We had several people offer to kind of take us in along the way. And some of those people were people that we had known previously or known through people. And then we had a couple situations where...
Complete strangers.
Total just pity. It's like, okay. Because we look pretty pathetic at the end of the day. When we crawl off the water, we're all scraggly and wet and... You know, we look awkward in the dry suits. So we're pretty pitiable. And so we had a couple situations where people were just kind and just took us in.
Imagine traveling 1,600 miles using only a paddle to propel yourself through the water. That's what these two women are doing. This is actually a map tracking their progress. They started their trip in New York and they're making their way to Key West. And I just checked on them. They're about to make their way here to West Palm Beach.
We made tons of new friends along the way. And I think I want to say it was surprising, but it was more than I anticipated it being. And a lot of that came from the social media aspect, because we were fundraising and all this stuff, so we had to get the word out. So we did little video updates and posts and photos, and so many people reached out to us that lived along the way or knew people that lived along the way. So we just, all of a sudden, we had this huge network of support and this enormous community that were super excited for us and encouraging us, and that also helped our morale a lot, because when we were feeling low, all of a sudden you have all of these amazing people like coming at you with this love and support and
encouragement.
That must have been amazing.
It was awesome.
It was our support, like literally. If it wouldn't have been for not only the paddling community along the East Coast, but our families, our friends, it was I don't think we would have made it through a week if it wasn't for the people who were around us, and not, you know, not physically around us, but supporting us in the distance. It would have been impossible.
Stay tuned next week when we talk to the Supper Girls about what's next after this historical journey.
Really cool how they use social media on their trip.
It's true. It's a useful tool that we utilize here on LIE. Mm-hmm. So we've got some pretty great programming coming up this month. Dr. Passis brought a new guest into the studio, mm-hmm. and all month long you can check him out with Dr. Klein, and he's got some useful medical advice. You want to see a clip?
Yeah, let's check it out.
All right, let's check it out.
So the other day, I'm on the phone, and I'm speaking to a doctor who works as a consultant for me when I have some questions in medicine that I need to get an answer. And I'm having a conversation about a patient with this doctor, and as we're talking and we're getting deeper and deeper into our conversation, it just hits me like a bell goes off in my head. And I just say to him, I say, Dr. Klein, I would like you and I to have these kind of conversations for the public on TV. What do you say we do this on TV, and we have the public get a good chance to understand more information? After all, information is power. And my good friend, Dr. Klein, said to me, I'd love to do it. He's a terrific guy. He's extraordinarily informed, and he agreed to come down. So I want you to sit back and relax. You might want to get a pen and some paper, because this is going to be one of those shows where you might want to write some things down, because you're going to learn a lot. It's going to be fun, informative, and interesting. So before we continue, without further ado, I want to bring to you Dr. William Klein. Dr. Klein.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
That was really cool.
Yeah, be sure to check it out, guys, on Mondays and Wednesdays here on PATV, Dr. Passis Presents.
And we also have another new show called Seniors for Seniors, starring Sabina Miller.
Yeah.
And we actually have a clip right here where you can learn a little bit more about taxes and records.
Oh, awesome. Let's check it out.
Hello, everybody. I'm back again. It's Sabina Miller. This program is for seniors, about seniors. I am senior, my guests aren't, but I have two fascinating guests today. And one is the town clerk for the town of North Hempstead, and the other is the receiver of taxes for the town of North Hempstead. And you may think, yes, I write checks to one and the other one just keeps records of things, but they actually have fascinating jobs. I would like to introduce Charles Berman and Wayne Wink. Oh. No, I was just told recently, and tell me if this is the truth, that if you are a veteran or the widow of a veteran, you get a 10% discount in your taxes?
Well, you do. You are entitled to a veteran's exemption. You certainly are if you're a veteran. There are actually three different types of veteran's exemptions. The oldest one being the eligible funds veterans, which was created for the World War II veterans and then the Korean War veterans. That was based upon a formula for how much money they actually received when they were in the service. And they were able to like increase the value of the exemption as time went on by doing certain things. They phased that exemption out in the 1960s and they replaced it with an exemption called the Alternative Veterans Exemption. And that basically gives the veterans 15% discount on their general taxes and a 25% discount if they were a combat veteran. So it's either 15 or 25. They actually now have something called a Cold War Veterans Exemption, which is relatively new. For veterans who served, you had to have been on active duty, but for veterans who served during peace times, which were in between all the wars that we fought, in the past, those veterans weren't entitled to veterans exemptions. Now they can get this Cold War exemption, and that's also 15%. But it's the way the law is written now, that one is only for a 10-year term.
And I have a question for you. Since you keep all these records, marriage certificates, birth certificates, death certificates, do people come in and want a copy?
Absolutely.
Why?
You'd be amazed how many people come in each and every day. For example, anyone who's on a public pension or even some private pensions, health insurance programs, as retirees. Recently, one of the state health insurance companies requested that all of their members who receive a family health insurance benefit, that they need to reprove the birth of their children or that their children are still dependents to them, as well as proving that their marriage still exists. You'd be amazed how many people came in to request a copy of their marriage license, or the marriage certificate, because people put it away. You know, they don't need to use it. Once they file jointly, once they have joint bank accounts, once everything is in the married couple's names, most people don't even think twice about a marriage certificate. But when an insurance company or a life insurance company wants proof that you were married at the time of your death, one of the things they want to see is your marriage certificate. Those are all housed. If you got your license in the town of North Hempstead, those are all housed in my office. Doesn't matter where you were married. You could be married in upstate New York, in Queens, in Manhattan, out in Montauk. As long as you received your license from the town clerk in the town of North Hempstead, whenever that was, that record will be available in my office.
Rebecca, what are you doing? We're live right now.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm just getting tired of the music I have. I want to hear something new. You know, I really like ukulele music, something different.
You don't say. Well, we just happened to have a ukulele performer on our last episode of The Brick Wall. The Brick Wall is our open mic style show, and we bring in musical guests, comedians, entertainers of all types, and they entertain us live Wednesday nights. And if you want to get involved, email patvbrickwall@gmail.com. Well, do you want to take a look at a clip
please,
of our ukulele
please,
player?
I'm going to check this out right now.
Roll it.
Prime time catch and release of the century, lying in the grass at sunrise. I could have just died. Now, I don't ask for much. No, I don't ask for much. Don't just sing Morrissey. to something. Beer and cigs and sticky summer nights. You stole the show that night. I just wanna kiss your neck, but I will keep that in check and let you come to me when you're done with Morrissey. Please don't sing Morrissey. Come and sit with me, please. No more Morrissey is gonna kill me. Good morning. I hope you slept well all through the night. You were snoring, kept me up until there was light. And maybe there's snow outside, but I don't care. 'Cause you had me to sleep by your side, and that's paradise for me every day.
One kiss, one smile, give me one more life. Victoria, 'cause I know the way I wanna feel tonight. Victoria. One smile, give me one more night, Victoria, 'cause I know the way I wanna feel tonight, Victoria.
Well, you know, the Brick Wall isn't the only place to check out live music on PATV.
That's right. We had a lot of concerts this summer in Great Neck Plaza, and a lot of our interns were out shooting these concerts. So it was a summer filled with music, and who doesn't love the Beatles? So check out this next clip.
This one was a big hit. Maybe you remember this one.
If you ever go to Firefighters Park in Great Neck Plaza, there's actually a beautiful monument for Jonathan Lee Ielpe, who Great Neck unfortunately lost on 9/11/2001. He was a firefighter, and this next clip is actually related to that.
Yeah, it's the 15-year anniversary of the tragedy of September 11th, and back in 2001, after we lost a brave firefighter, the mayor at the time, Rudy Giuliani, came to Great Neck to speak at his memorial service. Let's take a look at the clip.
This is a very, very sad day, and it's a very sad time. The enormity of the loss that we all feel is impossible to really describe. And there's nothing that I can say that's going to lift any of the burden or any of the sense of horror anger, maybe even fear that we have. But I think the thing that I would like to concentrate on just for a few minutes is the pride that we should feel in the accomplishment of Jonathan, of his brothers in the fire department, police department, emergency services people, all of the people who carried out the most effective and successful rescue mission that has ever been necessary in this country. We never had anything like that happen to us before. There's no comparison, there's no precedent, there's no textbook you can go to and read, well, what do you do when two of the largest buildings in the world are attacked by airplanes filled with 30,000 people in and around those buildings? All of the training, all of the preparation can't possibly prepare you for that. What you have to go on is instinct. The instinct that they went on was bravery and courage and dedication and love for other human beings. Love for other human beings to the extent that they went into the most horrible danger. I'd like you to know that they didn't lose their lives in vain. They saved over 25,000 people. The fire department of New York City, we've always known as the best fire department in the world. And now the whole world knows that the New York Fire Department is the best fire department in the whole world. There is no doubt about it. And it's important that the world know that now, because we need examples of courage. The attack that took place on the World Trade Center didn't happen for some vague reason. We're pretty clear now why it happened. It happened because we're a free country. It happened because we believe in political freedom, we believe in economic freedom, we believe in religious freedom. We value these things. They're at the core of what it means to be an American. We're not of one ethnic group, we're not of one race, we're not of one religion. We're united together because we believe in those things that I just mentioned. And the people who attacked us because those ideas are exceedingly dangerous to them. Jonathan and his brothers, in uniform, fought back with a kind of strength and courage that I believe demonstrates that not only will our ideas and ideals prevail, but our people will prevail. We're strong enough.
We had a jam-packed show today.
Yeah, we sure did. We heard from our producers, Sabina Miller and Harvey Passes.
We had that Beatles song with the Liverpool Shuffle. True.
We had the Supper Girls.
We had the Brick Wall, as always.
And we got to look at some footage from my flight lesson.
Flight.
Yeah, which reminds me, everybody, please use our hashtag, Long Island Skies. Send us your pictures, your tweets, anything. We'll put it on the air. And I think that's all we have time for, unless
I think we need a vibe of the week.
Ah, that's right. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Grace Grella with the vibe of the week.
Mike and Rebecca, thank you so much for that wonderful introduction. Feel the love, feel the vibes from Gigi. I'm throwing them your way. It's awesome that you two are just the greatest co-host since, I don't know, let's see. You're young, so you probably wouldn't remember Gracie Allen and George Burns, but nonetheless, you two are like the modern version of them, and that's a compliment. So lots of love. Thanks for introducing my segment. Vibes can only get better from here. I want to say that the vibes are all about appreciation, and that's why I was, sending the love your way. Too many people seem to be caught in the shade, and I know it's the summertime, and that's where it's supposed to be cool. But in the modern lingo, that throwing somebody shade is so not a good thing. So you two have it made in the shade. Shade is a good thing. You're the sunshine, and the shade is walking behind you. So both of you are going to have a fabulous week. I just wanted to throw the love your way and let you both know on a personal level. For everyone out there, there is going to be that aha moment, that revelation where you finally realize, you know what? I'm going to pick my battles. I'm going to choose my battles. And my peace of mind is worth more than winning or being right. And that's going to go a long way this week for you in creating positive, good vibes. And I hope you do, because remember, you are the love. Feel it. And until the next time, stay in the positive zone. Thank you.